Hello. Happy Thursday, everybody. Think I've got this set up the way I need to. And with that being said, I've just made my tweet, I've just made my Discord announcement, and it is time to get started. We're gonna do some Metal Slug tonight. And I have really been looking forward to get to this. Mostly just because it's been taking me a hell of a time to find a way to stream this properly. Without doing the Wii version, but we're going to be doing the Neo Geo original version. Great! That's a lot less fussing for me. Let me see here. I don't think my chat's working.
Uh-oh.
Ruh-roh. Ah, dear. I get no respect. No respect. Let me refresh my Twitch page. I had to at this point. Okay, there we go. Now things are rolling. Good, 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 good. Good. Let's not make my chat full screen, preferably. Okay. That's enough of that. Music. Thank you. Let's get into it. Been faffing around long enough, let's do it. And this is Metal Slug 3. I debated starting tonight with Metal Slug 2. This is the first time I've actually streamed a Metal Slug game on the channel. So this should be a lot of fun.
A lot of fun.
Just prepare to watch me die a lot. Been quite a bit of time since I've played these games. And do we have image? Yes, we do! Good. Let me know if the volume is too loud. We can adjust it if need be. Get going.
Heavy machine gun. Thank you.
Super. I have to move tabs. Video feed.
Grenade.
There you are.
Thank you.
Still is a bit loud. I'll just have to turn it down on OBS. Best I can do. Yep, this is an arcade game, and this is the arcade cabinet version of the game. So, it's the tried and true from the Neo Geo. Pop in a coin. Let's get going. Awesome power. So for those of you unfamiliar with the series, that right there is the Metal Slug. It's a little jumping tank. And of course, I can't play Metal Slug without playing as Fio. These images are great. I love the art in these games. We good? Yep, we are good. Let's get rolling. How's the frame rate going? That looks like it's doing okay. Not gonna be a whole lot of me jabbering, mostly just because I don't want to die too often. But we will see.
Thank you.
That machine gun, there you go. I hate these things. They pick you up and they snap your neck. It's very unpleasant. We'll see if I can do this whole first level without dying. That'd be pretty cool. I had to remember to go into the cabinet's BIOS and turn blood on, because by default it's actually turned off, which is funny. They look like they're sweating, or they bleed sweat, which is kind of weird. Yeah, fat! No, don't fall in the water, damn it. That's three prisoners in the water, that's great. That's gonna weigh on my conscience for years. Oh god. Oh god. That truck should have been dead by now. No, 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 no. Ah, I got popped. Well, fuck. There goes all the prisoners. Trying to get one to die on the boat so I can get ammo, but none of them dropped it, so. There we are. Giant enemy crab. Oh, well, look at that. I threw my tank at it. That's not quite what I meant to do. You press the jump and attack button at the same time. You send the tank flying, which kind of blows sometimes. Other times it works out, but that was not good. Heavy machine gun. I wanted the chick. Aw. If you keep the chick alive for long enough, it actually turns into a chicken. Wow, I am just sucking right off the bat. Oh, this is a good sign of things to come! You know why? It's because I'm not using a GameCube controller like I was used to doing for years. When you're actually using, like, stick and button, it kind of sucks. When you're not used to it. I just died already. No, there's another chick. Wow, that one got a lot more distance than I thought it would. Look at that, I gamed over already. Jeez. Aw, good first Metal Slug stream, huh? It's alright. There will be many more. Gotta shake off the cobwebs. Wow, I am shocked that this thing is not dead yet. God damn it. There it is. And he's gonna walk right off into the water. Well, goodbye, prisoner. Or, wait, no. Bridge is intact. Huh. Well, go figure. Mission two. Aw, this is a lot of fun. One of my favorite level concepts in the Metal Slug series, and I will show you why. Just as long as this guy over here doesn't get me. Out of the way, please. Yeah. I don't want that. Ah, fine. Aw, man, you ever, like, play games with cold fingers? All your joints are just locking up. Shit sucks. I'm gonna go down here, actually. There we go. Hi. Okay. Give me that thundercloud. Give me. Thundercloud. Monkey. Oh, monkey runs away. He doesn't like zombies. That's not the right way to puke! This way. Yeah, there you go.
You used to think the prisoners were cavemen. Yeah, for a time I, like, just thought they were, like, homeless dudes or something. Zombie doesn't give a fuck about these soldiers. They're hitting me with knives and grenades. Just like, whatever. I got this. Oh, but that guy, though. Yeah. If the zombies puke on you while you're zombified, you pretty much just saw what happened. I'll tell you something, streaming Metal Slug versus actually, like, dedicating all of your brain power to playing it, very different experience. Because you're going to have to get used to seeing a lot of that happening. Although I'm not dead, though, but
there we are.
Really. I actually think the shots from the gun when you're a zombie are a lot weaker. I would go into the cave, but I don't really feel like it tonight. When you play this game, you'll see that there's multiple paths you can go in certain levels. When I come back to this game another day, I'll show you some of the other paths. Oh, I hate these ones.
Rocket launcher!
It's a big'un! Usually they're teeny tiny little rockets. Normally I would get hit with a zombie before this boss fight, but I kinda don't feel like it. Well, alright then, never mind. I guess it's just going to happen anyways. Alright, the med kits are here. Okay, I wanna... Okay. Fine. I'm gonna try to avoid it. It's just something very off about those necks. I love the sound effects in this game. Okay. The Iron Lizard. You know, it took me years to understand that he was saying Iron Lizard. Because I was like, that thing looks nothing like a lizard when you shoot it. Lizard. So, I was just like, what the hell is he saying? Oh god. Okay, I brought plenty of quarters. I brought my whole allowance with me. Had enough of you guys. Heavy machine gun. Oh, this is gonna get bad really fast. I need that. Fuck. I saw that coming a mile away. Just like, I'll just accept it at this point. This is definitely one of the crazier entries. I think it's a fan favorite for a lot of people. Mission complete. I always seem to go back and forth between whether I like two or three more. I guess it just depends on the day.
We're swimming now.
I like these guys. Just blow themselves up. Jeez.
Thank you.
Oh god. Yes, this do has. This does have two-player co-op. Yes.
Yeet.
I don't want to go in a hole. You can go in that little tube down there, but I don't really want to. Go the paths that I'm used to. Wow. I swam right into that. Jeez. Tonight's catchphrase is gonna be, oh, jeez.
Thank you.
And
blah!
Yes, I would like to go in here. Yes, I would very much like to go in here. Thank you. Aw, jeez, Rick! No, no, no. Way, way down there. He landed on the rocket! Tricky jumps. I just love how animated the soldiers are. They always got, like, so many expressions. Oh, really? Did I? Nah. That's right, you gotta duck under those fireballs. Yes, ostrich! Yay! I like the ostrich. He's pretty chill. Pretty chill guy. Prefer not to die, though. So I can keep him. Nope. I did that thing again where I press jump and attack, and off he goes. Hi. Sometime today, please. Come on. Give it a thing. Thank you. Blech. Robot. Robot friend. Let me introduce you to my friend Laser. Yeah, he liked that. It's gonna get to the point where I'm just gonna see the death coming a mile away and I'm just gonna reach for the quarter. Yeah! Wow. When was the last time I played this, I wonder? It was the Wii version, I know that much. I'm just trying to remember when the hell that came out. It was quite some time ago. Oh, that's cool. It blows my mind to think that that was so long ago. Like, I was still in high school, I want to say. Or I was just coming out of it. But this game, Metal Slug 3, is 17 years old. And that just blows my mind when I think about that. Here we are. Nice face. I have infinite lives. No. But I do have a very big allowance, so there you go. I do a lot of very terrible things for quarters.
Thank you. Rocket launcher.
It makes you feel old, Mick, you're telling me. The only Metal Slugs that I've played on a Neo Geo cabinet, were... in the past, rather, were the first one and the fifth one, funny enough. The first one was when I was, let's see, I don't remember how old I was. I think I was like 13 or so? Yeah, that's cool. I'm gonna try to concentrate on two things at once, it's gonna be difficult. I was in Florida for something to do with my stepdad's business. Like, he had to go on a business thing, and he was near the coastline, so he just took the family with him. And, across the street from the hotel I was staying at, there was this just there's this tiny little arcade, just this beat-down little place that nobody was in. It was just one dude in there, just running the thing. And, I wander in, just because I'm bored, there's nothing to do during the day. I sunburn easily, so I'm just like, well, I don't really want to be on the coastline. And I see way in the back, there's a Neo Geo machine. And I freaked out, because I had only been, at the time, I had only been playing Metal Slug on some of the really, really early Neo Geo emulators. And so I fangirled when I saw this thing. So, I had to go back to the hotel room first. I had to see if my mom would give me some money. I'm gonna go in here. Like $5 or something. And I went to the change machine, just got a shit ton of quarters, and I played all the way through it, and it was awesome. Absolutely awesome. When I played 5, I was in Vegas with the girl I was dating at the time, and, let's see. I think the place was called Circus Circus, kind of a famous attraction over there. It's kind of like a casino slash indoor amusement park for kids, but they have an arcade there, so I checked it out, and lo and behold, they had... Whoops. Oh, down the hole I go then. Oh, I don't want to be in here. This place sucks. They had Metal Slug 5 in it. So that was fun for a little bit. Didn't really get a whole lot of time with it, though, unfortunately, because I was getting nagged. Like, I'm playing Metal Slug. So I... Just wait. Just let me have this.
No, I'm going to go ride the carousel.
Do you not understand? There's Metal Slug here! Get your priorities straight, woman. You stayed at Circus Circus when you were younger? That place is pretty cool! I remember winning a little teddy bear in a crane game. It's like the only crane game I've ever won in my life. Did I already pump that? I guess I did. Iron Lizard! He's definitely saying Iron Lizard. But do those look like lizards to you? They look like little mole people from Super Mario. Oh god. This place is gross. No. If I get hit with one of these things, it's pretty gross. I kind of melt.
Go.
And there's crabs in here! For some reason. Shotgun. Here we are. I wonder just how long it takes to, like, get the animations right for all these little pixel sprites. It never stops amazing me when I see it. Because it's like, I would love to have this kind of stylized animations in kind of pixel format if I ever make a game. I'm just like, god damn, that's gotta be really rough to do. And to make it look this good, too. Well, hi there.
Oh, jeez.
Well, that tank didn't last long, did it? I melted. Gross. Oh! Evo 2017, what is that? What is Evo? You've piqued my interest. I'm guessing it's in Vegas? Wow, I just, instead of dealing with the crabs, I decided to jump over them. Good thinking. It's actually kind of hard to look at chat and play this at the same time. I really wish I wouldn't have gone this way. I always have so much trouble with this part. It's a big fighting game tournament thing? Oh, okay. That'd probably be why I never heard of it. Not really much of a fighting game person. Slugs! Hi, Boogie. Oh, it's gonna be fun when I finish this and I see how many times I've continued. Really? You can shoot that far? Go away. Nope. Just right on your butt for a little bit. What a waste. Free ammo for nothing. Attorney of Keek Ponge and Track Suit. Heavy machine gun. Slug's coming for me. Slug's coming for me. And I walked into it. I will one of these times have to do a silent stream and just play this without talking. Because I'm not as bad as I'm making myself look right now. It's alright though. When I get back into the swing of things, I can start doing stuff like getting to level 4 without dying. Street Fighter V is going to be there. You know, I don't remember if it was Street Fighter V. I don't really keep up with the Street Fighters, but didn't that one kind of get, like, shitlisted by a lot of people? Or I guess people weren't really that happy with it. Come here. Don't want to get hit with that. Yeah. You explode into money if you get hit with that purple thing. It's actually pretty cool. Ooh! He got faster. Here come the dogs. It's always fun to get hit with the tail end of their animation. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Nope. Well, I guess it's good that I died before I picked that up. Any day now. There you are. No prisoners. So, for those of you who haven't played Metal Slug games, the prisoners you collect, if you keep them without dying, all the way to the end of the level, you get bonus points. Alright, let's see. I want that one.
Mission 5, start!
Why are the POWs falling from the sky? The prisoners? You know, I've never stopped and asked myself that. Huh. They do just kind of fall out of the sky sometimes. Maybe some kind of telekinetic force from that magical being I was just fighting. I was kind of holding him up in the sky. I don't know. Goodbye, Fio. I think I usually pick the jet when I start this level. I was just like, fuck it, helicopter. The jet has a different firing style than the helicopter, which I honestly think is a little easier to manage with this. Get out of here. Heavy machine gun. Rescue the piggies! I like that sound effect. That's a good one. I am just not keeping my vehicles. Pepino. That's Fio's teddy bear. Wow. I was concentrating so hard on dodging those bullets, I didn't even see that bright flickering bomb that was coming straight for me. Yeah, fuck those bananas, I'm not getting those. Oh, alright, that's as high as I can go on the screen. Alright, you know what? There you go. Here. There's the Babby Rockets.
Rocket launcher.
Sometimes it's better just to blow everything you've got. Just to get all the crap off the screen. Oh, that's funny. You can make her run on the hood of the truck. Never noticed that before. Just as long as I don't, like, accidentally jettison myself out of it again, I'm happy. No! Oh, missile, please. Excuse me. See you later, helicopter. Whoa. Did that thing just glide into me like that? How rude. Oh, it's that guy. Can't remember his name right now. Dude's a motherfucker. Kinda went away though. He'll be back. There he is. Come on, boy! I'll take that. They're all running away. Good. Just mowing them down. Yeah, this is mine now. I think the name of the buff dude was Alan O'Neill, if I remember correctly. And I think that's Morden, this fella up here in the chopper. He's kind of like the main antagonist of the series. Just gotta take him out. I mean, I gotta admit, he's handling getting hit by a stationary turret pretty damn well. Taking it like a champ. Nope. Oh, that was lucky. I mean, geez, look at him. He's just... he's really taking these bullets. There we are. And he's done. He was getting taken away! Now Fio's been kidnapped and we gotta go after her. So Marco's gonna step in. This is where things start to get a little crazy. I think it's so cool if you like kind of watch the background, you can see the now ally soldiers are kind of getting blown up in the big fight, rather. Biggs!
In space!
I wish I would have shot that.
Ow.
Do not lose Rocket. Nope. Jesus. Really sucks not having both of my turrets. Oh wait, guess what, I have them back now. You can get yourself screwed if you shoot all three of those. Shotguns on a rocket. That's pretty damn cool. Okay, good, I didn't just screw myself. I got a little nervous, I saw two of them shatter. Give me that. Gas refills your vehicle's health. Might actually be the longest I've kept the rocket. Which is very nice for these giant UFOs. Oh. Collected two weapons. And I pressed jump and attack. Go figure. I don't even need to press jump here. I somehow still hit the button. God damn it. Nope. Good things aren't meant to last, I suppose. I just love the little aliens and their little UFOs. They're so cute. Okay, this thing needs to go now. Pepinos everywhere. Just let those bounce around for a little while. Just rockets everywhere. They will eventually go off screen, though. Oh, no, that's fine. Ah! I was alive for a while there. Staying alive for the duration of this entire level is insanity. Because this is an extremely long level. And you'll see what I'm talking about here. Rocket launcher. Finally. It's always nice when those things line up and fall into you because you can't move your character right now. Prefer not to pick up all of those, but it's fine. Get the big rockets. Fuck!
Heavy machine gun.
This guy just won't give me a break. If you really feel like hating yourself sometime, go into the arcade's BIOS and set the difficulty level to the highest one. It just makes it stupid hard. Also, if you get motion sick from watching these types of, like, scrolling backgrounds, I recommend just kind of, like, shutting your eyes for the next, I don't know, 5 minutes or so. Because I know some people kind of get motion sickness from this type of thing. And it doesn't get any better. It just gets worse. These things. I remember these.
Heavy machine gun. Laser gun. Laser gun.
Definitely want to keep the lasers for this. Just because these little shitheads start getting in the way. Give me that laser. Give me! Thank you. That chaser is tempting. Oh, I guess I'm taking it. Actually does help quite a bit. I will let you know when the scrolling background has stopped. I think we're pretty close to getting done with this section. Go through three of these walls. I looked at the OBS window for a second to see if the frame rates were holding up. Damn it. Came out of the corner. This part always seems like it goes on for way longer than it should. Almost? No. Not yet. Damn it! I still got it. More of these. Yeah, fuck that. No. Still got hit. There we are. And you may now resume viewing. They're like little spaghetti aliens. And they shoot like popcorn out of their guns. This is some bullshit right here. This game must have been a quarter sucking machine. Just a quarter black hole. Like you can open any time now. I always like watching that guy get zapped. And it just keeps going. So now the enemies are on my side. Oh, these little guys suck. I want that. Because they explode. Try to rescue this guy, but I never can! Mobs. Mobile satellite! You don't really see this upgrade very often, but it... Oh, it's so nice to have here. Just, I mean, look at it. It's tearing them right apart. Right until it gets to this thing. It's like I can focus on dodging. Yeah, you do not want to be standing on one of those things when they come crashing down. Yeah, good. Oops, that's not where those meant to go. Oh, man! I got pincered. It's like, do I hit the bubble or do I get squished? A whole lot of good stream dialogue tonight. Just a whole lot of me going, oh! Oh, I hate this. Come on. Get me in there! Ah, what is this thing called? It's got a name. Just can't think of it right now. Right it in my face. Better to run away from the damn thing half the time. Oh god.
Prefer not to die, please.
Oh god. Just squeeze through. Still going. Oh, fuck this part. Fuck this part right in the mouth. Yeah, you fat. This part always breaks my heart a little bit, because I gotta kill the Fios. I mean, the dirty clones, but still. I don't enjoy my work. Assassin Marco does not enjoy his work.
Armor Piercer!
Enough of you already.
Armor Piercer!
Oh. Alright then. Bye, Metal Slug. I'm still fat! Yeesh! I want the fish. Give me the fish. Oh my god, look at the size of my shotgun shots. Because I'm fat and it's the super one. I don't want to lose this. Are you kidding me? Aw, of course. Fine. I have a little whip. Aw, fat mode is the best. Hey, it's Alan, I think. I think his name's Alan. Alan O'Neill. Now he's helping me out. Even though he just sits there laughing half the time. He'll, like, get a shot off and then he'll start laughing. Yes, 0 points. That will happen sometimes. There are items that give you 0 points. There's Fio! Oh, I'm not fat anymore. Yeah, fuck fighting these things if you have no weapons. Because they will just rip and tear. Great. But they have weapons. There she is. Out you go. Yep, let's go. Oh boy. What I meant to say earlier was fuck this part right in the mouth. Please. I have no grenades. Ugh. Go, go, go. Go. And that one's coming up on the left pretty fast. Nope. Oh god. Oh god. Come on. Get it, get it, get it! Oh, go. Get out! Ah! I couldn't get away. Yeah, These things, you need weapons or bombs or something. The bombs have feet! Try my best not to attack and jump at the same time. I'm so glad they made a dedicated button for it in the fifth game. I mean, these damn Neo Geo cabinets have four buttons! Use the last one! It's never used until the fifth one. Or maybe the fourth one. I don't know. I don't play the fourth one much. Surprisingly not getting hit much. Like, what's going on with that? I mean, I want this thing. This might have been a mistake. This might have been a huge mistake. It's okay. No regrets! Punch! Punch! Punch your way through! Still can't select Fiyu. One can only hope she made it out. Because she had to get through all this bullshit and I don't see how. Fuck. I mean, look how fast they go. There she is. Got sucked out into space. Gross. Okay, keep the slug alive. Of course. Couldn't avoid the one thing. Well, so much for the slug. I tried. Oh, I don't have any more bombs! This is so hard! It never gets easier! Oh, I'm so rusty. I'm getting hit by the slightest thing on the screen. It's just whatever. Just die, give me bombs. Let's wrap this up. It's fine. I died on the first level. I have no shame anymore. All expectations are out the window. There's Fiyu!
Fiyu's alive!
Nope. Not dodging that. I jumped off! Ah. I think this thing is called, like, Root Mars or something like that? Rude Mars? R-O-O-D-M-A-R-S? Oh my god. Fiyu, shoot more. And there's a crab. What the hell? Do you see that? There was a crab! My mind couldn't parse that. Ugh. I am eating all the dicks right now. I think I ought to shoot down with the heavy machine gun. That'd probably help, wouldn't it? Oops. Wrong way. Oh, you can't shoot those? Alright. You can only shoot the orange one. Well, he's dead anyways. It's nice of Fio to keep pace with me in her little UFO as I plummet to the earth. Mission complete. God, that was a long-ass level.
Mission all over.
26? No, that's not as bad as I thought. Well, advantages of having a three-letter name. There you are. How many quarters per continue? It depends on how the owner of the cabinet sets it in the BIOS. I can actually show you here once the credits roll. You can actually set a lot of things. You can turn blood off, you can set the amount of lives you get per continue. You can actually turn free play mode on. But there's always something so satisfying about making that credit counter go up. I remember, one day when I was very bored, I took my TI-86 calculator, and in the graph mode, you can actually do pixel art with it, if you know what you're doing. And I drew this gun in it, pixel for pixel. I thought that was pretty fun. I don't think the whole thing fit on the screen, though, just because it's so big. My bad. But yeah, you can make it like 2 quarters per continue. You can set the damn thing pretty high. But I remember, in Pennsylvania, I knew this arcade in a mall that I used to go to, the La Trobe Mall, and the dude who ran the place was, like, kind of a smart tech guy. He really knew how to work arcade machines, but he was also kind of a dick, too. So what he would do is, he would crank up the difficulty and the amount of quarters per play in all of his cabinets. A dick. My score. Ape, bat, cat, eel, fox, something. I just realized all of those are alphabetical. Ape, bat, cat, dog, fox. Huh. Interesting. But let me show you the BIOS real quick. So this is the BIOS of the arcade cabinet, and what you can do, let's see, you can do a hardware test, which, you know, is nice. And now it's frozen. So I shouldn't have done that. Let's reset that. You go to the soft dip menu. You go to the middle slug 3. So this is the lives. I mean, you can crank this thing way up if you want to. All the way. Or go backwards. Set it 2, 1.
continue on off. You can make it so that they can't continue the game. It's like, it's one quarter for the whole game. Difficulty level sets the AI, and actually does change quite a bit. Enemies are more accurate, grenades are faster, things like that. The timer at the top of the screen, which usually is pretty negligible, like, you can kind of ignore it most of the time, but, you know, some people are very cautious when they play, but you can be like, well, I guess 60 is the lowest, so never mind. But you can give them more time if you want to. Demo sound. You can make it so that it's quiet when it runs the game demo. You can make it so that it skips the intro. I think this turns on and off the credit counter and the level counter at the bottom of the screen. By default, the level number displayed at the bottom is disabled, but the credit is enabled. And you can set the language of the machine. Pretty cool. And this is, interestingly enough, this is turned off by default just because, you know, parents in the 90s and all that. And if there were soldiers on the first level, I would kind of show you what it does. It kind of looks like gray spraying out of them instead of, like, blood. I mean, clearly it's blood. You can just tell it's blood. But yeah, that's kind of neat. Turn that back. There we go. Setting up the cabinet. So here's where you set the coin amounts. So you can go 2 coins per credit, or you can do 1 coin equals 2 credits. That's pretty neat. Interestingly enough, by default on Neo Geo cabinets, and a lot of people who buy these things don't know this, by default, the Player 2 slot actually gives you 2 credits per 1 coin. So I guess they made it that way so that you could, if you wanted to play with 2 people, you could just slip it into the second slot. But I mean, if you don't, you just get... but I think it counts it towards the second slot, so it is weird. I'd have to play with it. Game select only when credited. Quite remember what this option does. This has a timer when you insert a quarter. So, like, let's say you can't just drop a bunch of quarters in it and then walk away and then come back to it later with the credit still in it. Like, if you put a credit on the title screen, there will be a timer and it starts. But I think I might be able to turn this off. Let's see. Without. There you go. I don't know if that means that it starts right away or... I don't know. We'll find out. Demo sound set up in each. Out. Huh. I think this is the sound for the tutorial. Let's find out. Let's tinker with some things. Go. And we will leave the difficulty way high. Turn the demo sound off so you can see that. Give myself, like, whoops, not too fast now. Not too fast. Say 20 lives? That's fine. That's plenty. And interestingly enough, they have a built-in calendar on the cabinet. So you can see it says it's January 26th, 2017. Which I always thought was interesting because when I had played, I guess maybe I had seen the original BIOS. This was before the year 2000, and like not on an actual arcade, mind you. And I didn't expect the year timer to roll over, but then, you know, I didn't really consider that because I was a young, dumb kid. But let's see what the results are. So if we wait for the demo, see, it's all quiet now. Very, very quiet.
And you know, it's actually kind of nice that some of these arcade machines have that, just because I actually remember in a car repair store that my dad went to, and I was just with him. He had to get like some extensive work on his car, and we had to wait in the waiting lobby for a very long time, but they had an arcade machine, and I just remembering that the demo sound was very quiet, but then once you started the game, it was like loud. Normally this makes a sound, but let's put it in a quarter. So yeah, it, without means that there is no timer to start the game, so that's kind of cool. Oh hey, it's airy now. That's cool. I didn't realize it cycles characters on the intro screen. You can actually skip this. So let's see what the difficulty increase did. I have 19 lives and I'm probably gonna need them. Oh god, look how fast they move now. Still manageable until you get to enemies with weapons, then it just goes nuts. Actually, if they shoot bubbles, I wonder. Oh yeah, the bubbles are moving a little quicker. Could just be my imagination, though. That didn't mean to knock her on her butt. Damn it. I don't like not having super grenade right here. Okay, things seem like they're moving a lot faster. No! Gross. Gross. I think it would be a fun stream to go through this game sometime and show you all the, like, unique character deaths and stuff. Not to mention, there's tons of paths you guys didn't even get to see. See if I can get someone to shoot a weapon at me. Huh. Interesting. I think the variance in difficulty is a lot more noticeable in, like, the very first game. Like, bullets are much more accurate, they have sharper angles they can go at. Let's see. There's probably going to be a lot more bombs coming out of this truck. Maybe? Or just none at all? What the hell? Oh god, here they come! Whoa! Okay, so they're just really fast. But they barely come out? That's really weird. Huh. Did I, like, goof up the difficulty? I thought I set it to 8. Pop. Heavy machine gun. Hmm, maybe the fishies will be faster. No, yeah, they're still the same. Oh, wait a minute. Give me that. See if the crab boss is any different. Doesn't really seem like it. Try setting it to level 1 after this and see what it does. Oh no, chick, come back! Oh good, it's still here. Check it out, it'll grow up. if it has enough time. Oh, I didn't actually hit it! Damn it. Alright, well anyways, let's see. Set it to level 1. No manual, please. Let's do it in Spanish. Actually, if we're gonna do it in Spanish, I do want the demo on. This is for Kazi. Let's do it in Spanish. Yes, we're done. Yep, that's definitely Spanish. Saltar. Grananda. Incredible! Actually, that was French, the way I pronounced incredible. Oh well. Escape! Enemigo. Enemigo! I didn't realize that enemy was just, like, amigo with, like, the prefix of enemy on it. That's actually pretty great. Mission one. Okay, now let's see the difficulty. Maybe I had it backwards. No, they just got wiped out with a single bullet. Look at that. Or maybe those first three are just easier to kill. Man, I have so many questions. Let's see what the grenade throwers are like. Huh. Doesn't really seem all that different, does it? I should have turned blood off just to show you what that was like, but I mean, it's really nothing special. Just imagine, instead of red blood, it's like gray. It's not really that interesting. Alright, let's watch the bomb truck. Okay, well, the bombs are definitely moving much slower, but there's more of them. Weird. Very weird. Yeah, fat!
Thank you.
I almost got him. Do you see how that one fish dropped ammo? That's why I like to try to wait for them. But that can be tricky. Is it without dying? Alright, Crab, you any different? You might have less health overall. Okay, that seemed like that happened a lot quicker. Oh wow, that was really fast. See, it does adjust things in very minor ways. Interesting. Sometime I'll show you what it's like in the first game, you can definitely tell the difference. Well, anyways. Set all my stuff back to the way I had it. Otherwise, I'll forget to do it. Oops.
Okay. Sure. I think that was the way I had it. Cool. Here you go. That's Metal Slug 3. Just thought we'd play with the arcade cabinet a little bit for a little bit of extra content. Like I said, it was going to be a bit of a shorter stream tonight, but I will be coming back to this for sure, mostly just because I absolutely love Metal Slug. Big, big fan of the series. And there's a lot of games. There's 7 of them, if you don't include Metal Slug X. And I guess now there's Metal Slug XX, which is just 7, but different. I haven't played that one yet, though. So. I've played 7 for the DS, but not the PSP version. But with that being said, I'm going to get going. And I hope you guys liked Metal Slug. I'll definitely have something a bit longer for tomorrow if I stream. Probably not going to do it on Saturday because I'm going to go out with Tim. And there's a place around here called 16-Bit, and it's a barcade. And I've never been to a barcade before. I'm not talking like Dave & Buster's. This is like an actual bar with arcade machines in it. Kind of a smaller time gig. So we're going to go check it out. It should be pretty cool. I'll think about what to stream tomorrow. I'm still kind of torn between Phoenix Wright and something else. If you guys want to see one thing over the other in particular, just say it in the chat now before I go. But other than that, I wish you all a good night, and thank you for watching. Take care.